Tonight, after several failed attempts to raise the Solway Harvester, divers have now recovered the bodies of the seven fishermen. And renewed concerns over fatal military air crashes. Now a campaign starts to lobby MPs and MSPs.
Good evening. Also on the programme, police investigating the brutal killing of a father of two are following up new leads.
A man has appeared in court on drugs charges after heroin was seized in Carlisle. And why they're being told to forget Wordsworth and the other famous Lake poets this weekend.
In sport, we look ahead to the big kick-off in Rugby Union's Six Nations Championship. The region's football sides prepare for some crucial matches. And riding high, the youngster who's tipped for the top.
The bodies of all seven of the young men lost when their scallop dredger sank off the Manx coast last month have been recovered. The announcement came this afternoon following a series of successful dives by experts from the support vessel, the Weld Servicer. The dive was authorised following a great deal of planning by specialists after a series of attempts to raise the Solway Harvester from the seabed had failed.
The families of the crewmen recovered have been informed and are expected to return to the Whithorn area over the next few days. The operation to raise the wreck will now resume when the weather improves.
The decision to at least temporarily abandon efforts to raise the wreck of the Solway Harvester was made by the Isle of Man's Chief Minister Donald Gelling this morning. It followed a series of aborted attempts to lift the vessel from her resting place off the Manx coast, the latest of which last night provided the first glimmer of real hope for nearly a week. With the elaborate winching and harness equipment in place, for a time the Solway Harvester was actually on her way back to shore, but the mission was ended when it had only barely begun by the elements. This morning, Mr. Gelling said it was time to end the wait endured by the families of the seven men that were lost when the scallop dredger sank last month.
Yes, I think the families themselves, having spoken to them last night myself, they feel a lot of comfort in actually being here. They were feeling again, although they were being kept very much in touch with what was going on, they were a distance away from us. Now that they're here and talking about it, I think that has been a comfort to them. We now want to, if we can, really get this recovery as soon as possible so that they and the bodies of their loved ones can go back to Whithorn and to the Scottish area where they've come.
This afternoon came the news the families had hoped and prayed for. The divers recovered the bodies of all seven of the young men lost when the Solway Harvester sank in stormy seas. All seven were brought aboard the support vessel, the Well Servicer, and relatives and friends immediately informed. Inquests will now be opened in the island before the bodies are released for burial in Dumfries and Galloway. The operation to raise the wreck, though, will continue as soon as the weather allows. There is great determination to find out what happened to the men and their vessel on the 11th of January this year.
Well, joining me now on the telephone from the Isle of Man is Paul Shotton, a marine consultant to the Isle of Man government. Good evening. First of all, if you can tell me then how the operation went this afternoon.
The operation went very successfully. We have had the good fortune to find all seven bodies of the crewmen on the vessel. The divers entered the wreck around about midday and went on to search an area of the wreck that hadn't previously been investigated, and in doing so they located the other four bodies. They were all recovered to the surface at about 2:45 and are now being returned to the shore.
This all seems to have happened very quickly and relatively simply. Why wasn't it done before, some people might ask?
It has been the culmination of a week's preparation. This was always a fallback contingency for us, and it has been driven by the weather. At the moment, the weather is not very pleasant out in the bay where the vessel is working.
So, and Mr. Shotton, you're saying it would have been impractical before?
Totally impractical. When we first found the wreck, it was lying on its side. It was covered in debris. There were far too many hazards to the divers. And also, I must stress that this was always a fallback situation, in that if you're searching an area for remains of forensic evidence. The last place you want to do it is underwater in a restricted visibility situation.
The preference
is always to do it on surface, and that's why our prime target has always been to recover the wreck to the surface.
Mr. Shotton, thank you very much indeed for joining us.
Okay, you're welcome. Bye.
The working group which monitors low flying across the region is to contact MPs and MSPs amid concerns over the increase in serious plane crashes.